Plutonium was totally unknown before 1940. It was first discovered when it was artificially synthesized in experiments exploring the effects of bombarding uranium with a beam of neutrons.
From there, it was how do you purify the plutonium, turn it into a weapon, and then manufacturing the weapon. The military was looking to have a new facility built to produce weapons. Rocky Flats was the decision. And they started the building, and they started with putting in plutonium. Early on, because of the lack of knowledge and experience in the field of nuclear weapons and handling plutonium uranium, we didn't have all the safeguards and safety measures that we needed. But as we progressed through time, those things were corrected and improved upon.
Updating supplied air systems, shielding, air sampling, all that. And we did a lot of it.
While the site was operating, that was fine. But when the site started to close, everything had to leave. The weapons material, the components, the waste.
And the development of those final cleanup levels was a combined effort of DOE, EPA, the state, all the local municipalities, and several other individual interested parties.
The final boundary between the peripheral operable unit and the central operable unit was drawn so the central operable unit would include all those areas that required any remedial actions.
There's plutonium at residual levels attached to soil particles out there, but they're not a high enough concentration where they cause an exposure to either human health or the environment.
And the resulting decisions from that to release that peripheral operable unit land and allow the Fish and Wildlife Service to manage that site as a refuge. The refuge is safe.